Yes, he has appeared once for all to take away sin. The Lamb of God was slain, taking away the sins of the world, but the blood is still working.
Welcome to the Building Faith Families podcast with Steve Demme. I'm your host, Scott Moore. Thanks for joining us today.
Good morning, Steve. How are you today?
I am well. I have had 3 days to recuperate from our conference. How do you like that?
That's good.
How are you?
I'm recuperating from being sick.
Oh, no.
Nah, it's fine. It's not that terrible. It's just one of those ones that makes life annoying, but you can still do everything. So, you know.
I totally get it. I had it for a couple of weeks.
Yeah.
Good days, bad days, off, on. Yeah, I can still function, but barely.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
I'm doing better than barely, so that's pretty good. You know, as illnesses go, this one's fine. I don't need to gripe about it.
Well, we had our first midwinter conference since COVID. It was awesome. Started planning it in the fall, and 2.5 weeks ago, I thought I was going to lose my shirt, and then a whole bunch of people signed up in the last 2 weeks, and we met Friday and Saturday in Lancaster, Pennsylvania, and it was awesome. And we started off connecting. What's that word make you think?
Instant bonds of relationships? I don't know.
Well, we were connecting with God and each other. And so what we did was we started off. And I said, okay, I want everybody to stand up and go find two other people that you don't know. And there's the questions on the front of your handout. I had 8-page handouts. And the question said, you know, how many children are you homeschooling? What was one of your highlights since September? What's one of your challenges? And each person did it. And then, but the thing was, is that I got the feedback forms and the introverts were the ones that were saying, I really like that because I made a friend. So
cool.
Connecting with each other. And then we drew near to God based on the principles of Psalm 100. So we made a joyful noise, shout. We sang a hymn. We gave thanks to God. We praised his name based on one of his character qualities. And we did 2 of those pages. And it was just awesome. And God did. I don't know how to tell you, but the whole atmosphere was just sweet from beginning to end because we put God first. And I'm hoping all conferences will do this because these principles work. This is not just like a liturgy that you go through the motions. That God says, if you will come into my presence this way, I will meet with you. And he met with us, and it was evident. So we had workshops, and we had... It was only a 9-to-5 thing, and we had it on Friday, and we had it on Saturday. But me, that was the highlight, was connecting with God and getting to know other people. So,
very cool.
Yeah. So then I died Saturday night. I came home. I didn't know if I could even get into my pajamas to go to bed. I almost just laid on my bed in my clothes. But got up, and then Sunday was not too bad. Got another nap, and then grandkids came, so... Still looking for air, and then got a really good night's sleep Sunday, and Monday caught up a little bit, and here I am Tuesday. So, okay, so now I'm ready to sing a song to start. You ready?
Let's do it.
Okay. Arise, my soul, arise, shake off your guilty fears, the bleeding sacrifice in my behalf appears. Before the throne my surety stands, before the throne my surety stands, my name is written on his hands. Now I'm going to read the next 4. 5 bleeding wounds he bears, received on Calvary. They pour effectual prayers, they strongly plead for me. Forgive him, oh forgive, they cry, nor let that ransom sinner die. The Father hears him pray, his dear anointed one. He cannot turn away the presence of his son. His spirit answers to the blood and tells me I am born of God. I have been reconciled. His pardoning voice I hear. He owns me for his child. I can no longer fear. With confidence I now draw nigh and Father, Abba, Father, cry. He ever lives above for me to intercede, his all-redeeming love, his precious blood to plead. His blood atone for all our race and sprinkles now the throne of grace. Isn't that amazing? I sing this song a lot because we have guilty fears. We just do. We deal with guilt. We deal with shame because of sin. But the Lamb of God appears with our names written on his hands. And then there are five bleeding wounds also on his hands and feet and side. And they are crying out to God, forgive him. Don't let this ransomed sinner die. The Father hears the blood. And his spirit answers to the blood and tells me, I am born of God. I've been reconciled. He owns me for his child. His blood continues to plead for me. Whew. Let's pray. Father, thank you for your blood that spoke once and speaks all the time. Thank you for the living, powerful gospel that we have participated in and are participating in. Bless us today as we consider you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
This was my big revelation yesterday. I was seeking God. I was outside. It was 60 degrees. It was an abnormally warm day. And I thought of these different aspects of God, and that one thought kept going over and over. These transactions that God has done for us are one time and all time. We know that he offered one sacrifice for sin once. He doesn't have to keep going back into the tabernacle. He doesn't have to keep offering himself up. It is a once and done. However, there are people in Revelation that are still washing their robes in the blood of the Lamb. So yes, he has appeared once for all to take away sin. The Lamb of God was slain, taking away the sins of the world. But the blood is still working. It's still effective. It's still, I shouldn't say flowing, but that's the word that I'm thinking. So that makes sense?
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to just read a whole bunch of passages. We're in the New Testament now. We started in Genesis and Exodus. We went through Leviticus. We read Hebrews. We've read Gospels. And now we're going to talk about the appearance of the blood in Paul's writing, John's writing, Peter's writing. Everyone has sinned, Romans 3:23. We all fall short of God's glorious standard, yet God, with undeserved kindness, declares that we are righteous. He did this through Christ Jesus when he freed us from the penalty of our sins. For God presented Jesus as the sacrifice for sin. People are made right with God, or justified, when they believe that Jesus sacrificed his life, shedding his blood. This sacrifice shows that God was being fair when he held back and did not punish those who sinned in times past, for he was looking ahead and including them in what he would do in this present time. God did this to demonstrate his righteousness, for he himself is fair and just, and he declares sinners to be right in his sight when they believe in Jesus. There is so much packed into here. It's a newer translation, but I think it helps us to grasp these different concepts. The first one is that God is righteous. And when we sin, we deserve to die. We need someone to die in our place. So Jesus sacrificed his life. He shed his blood. And now God holds back and doesn't punish those. Okay, So the fancy word for this is to appease, to assuage, to reconcile, to give a propitiation. This propitiation, this word is amazing because it has both components. There's wrath towards sin. And it should be. The soul that sins shall die. But there's also reconciliation because God offered up the atoning sacrifice, the perfect sacrifice. His son did what nobody else could do in heaven or on earth. This lamb that was slain for our sins assuaged and appeased his wrath. We are now justified. I'm going to keep reading. Romans 5, 8 through 11. God showed his great love for us by sending Christ to die for us while we were still sinners. And since we have been made right in God's sight by the blood of Christ, he will certainly save us from God's condemnation. For since our friendship with God was restored by the death of his son while we were still his enemies, we will certainly be saved through the life of his son. So now we can rejoice in our wonderful new relationship with God because our Lord Jesus Christ has made us friends of God. His wrath has been appeased and assuaged. His condemnation has been cared for because of the blood. And now we, and it's, the word is used there a couple times, friendship with God restored. We were enemies at one point, and now we have a wonderful new relationship, and we are friends of God. Purchased. I'm going to focus on a couple verses about this. Acts 20:28, Paul says to the elders, guard yourselves and God's people. Feed and shepherd God's flock, his church, purchased with his own blood, over which the Holy Spirit has appointed you as elders. His blood purchased us. His blood, you might say, made all the difference because the prince of the power of this air, the God of this world, owned us because we'd sinned and we were condemned to die, and his blood bought us. Ephesians 1, even before he made the world, God loved us and chose us in Christ to be holy and without fault in his eyes. God decided in advance to adopt us into his own family by bringing us to himself through Jesus Christ. This is what he wanted to do, and it gave him great pleasure. So we praise God for the glorious grace he has poured out on us who belong to his dear Son. He is so rich in kindness and grace that he purchased our freedom with the blood of his Son and forgave our sins. And when he purchased us, he brought us near. 1 John 2:2, he is the propitiation for our sins, and not for ours only, but also for the sins of the whole world. Ephesians 2:13, you have been united with Christ Jesus. Once you were far away from God, but now you have been brought near to him through the blood of Christ. Colossians chapter 1, same thought. God, in all his fullness, was pleased to live in Christ, and through him God reconciled everything to himself. He made peace with everything in heaven and on earth by means of Christ's blood on the cross. This includes you who once were far away from God. You were his enemies, separated from him by your evil thoughts and actions. Yet now he has reconciled you to himself through the death of Christ in his physical body. As a result, he has brought you into his own presence, and you are holy and blameless as you stand before him without a single fault. That is powerful. Ransomed. You know that God paid a ransom to save you from the empty life you inherited from your ancestors, and the ransom he paid was not mere gold or silver. It was the precious blood of Christ, the sinless, spotless Lamb of God. God chose him as your ransom long before the world began, but he has now revealed him to you in these last days. That's 1 Peter 1, 18 through 20. Revelation 5, I saw a lamb that looked as if it had been slaughtered. You are worthy to take the scroll and break its seals and open it, for you were slaughtered, and your blood has ransomed people for God from every tribe and language and people and nation. And this blood not only restores us and ransoms us and pays for our sins and reconciles us to God, this blood purifies us. 1 John 1:7, if we are living in the light as God is in the light, then we have fellowship with each other. And the blood of Jesus, his son, cleanses us from all sin. Revelation 1:5, Jesus Christ is the faithful witness to these things, the first to rise from the dead and the ruler of all the kings of the world. All glory to him who loves us and has freed us from our sins by shedding his blood for us. Revelation 7:14. These are the ones who died in the great tribulation. They have washed their robes in the blood of the Lamb and made them white. And not only does this blood wash us from sin, reconcile us to God, justify us, it overcomes the devil. Revelation 12, I heard a loud voice shouting across the heavens, it has come at last, salvation and power in the kingdom of our God and the authority of his Christ. For the accuser of our brothers and sisters has been thrown down to earth, the one who accuses them before our God day and night. And they have defeated him by the blood of the Lamb and by their testimony, and they did not love their lives so much that they were afraid to die. Blesses me just doing the homework on this. It blesses me reading these passages. It blesses me believing these passages. Okay, my blessed co-host, what do you think?
So I already took a shower today. However, I feel like my soul just got a bath.
Amen.
I mean, I kind of know how else to describe it. Like this, like I love reading the Old Testament, and there's lots of great stuff. We can find Jesus there. It's beautiful. But when I just need to be reminded of this stuff, man, just I can just listen to this podcast again. Just hearing you read all those verses, like, oh my gosh, I just feel this weight lifting, and like I just want to praise God.
Amen. You're going to make me cry because I feel the same way. There's power in the blood of Jesus and reading it. And, you know, we know faith comes from hearing, hearing by the word of Christ. But these passages that God has brought together here are just astounding. I don't know if I want to wreck it with a song, but I have to. You ready?
Sure.
For nothing good have I, whereby thy grace to claim, I'll wash my garments white in the blood of Calvary's Lamb. Jesus paid it all to him I owe. Sin had left a crimson stain, he washed it white as snow.
Amen.
Isn't that awesome?
I love that song. Yeah.
Yeah. There's so many songs. O Sacred Head Now Wounded. I was thinking of the song. There's power in the blood. They're rich and they're biblically based. That's the point. They're not just hopeful. They are truthful. Father, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. We're going to have an eternity to give thanks to you, and I'm looking forward to it. And I don't think it's going to be tiring. I don't think it's going to be repetitive. Our eyes are going to continue to be opened to the majesty and the power and the long, far-reaching implications of the blood of Jesus. That was the event that has changed history. And that is the event that broke the power of the devil. And that death of Jesus on the cross, when the water and the blood poured from his being, that spelled not only our salvation and new rebirth and hope, but it also spelled the end of death and the end of the devil. You were manifested. You were revealed to destroy the works of the devil. And someday you're going to wipe away every tear. And we won't even know what tears are for or why we even shed them in the past. Thank you for the power of the blood of Jesus. Thank you for shedding. Thank you, Father, for watching it happen. Thank you, Spirit, for helping Jesus to give his life for our sins. We worship you today in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
And that's our show for this week, folks. Thanks for joining us for the Building Faith Families podcast with Steve Demme. If you have a question for the show, email Steve at spdemme@gmail.com. If you have a question for me, you can reach me at scott@unsocializedmedia.com. Thanks for joining us. Have a great week.